Hey, yo, what's up? How's it going, everybody? So this is going to be our week 7 match of the BBL. Now, this was supposed to go up last week, but just had been busy, I suppose. So you guys might get a doubleheader here on Monday. If not, then week 8 will be up tomorrow for sure. Then that way we can catch up and be back on track to being on schedule for the rest of the season here, which ends by week 10. So, we are taking on Q the Costa Rican. Never played him before. Definitely check him out, guys. For those of you who saw my Who Wants the Battle tag video for 2020, this was the Q the Costa Rican I was talking about. I don't know how many Q the Costa Ricans there are, but he's the only one that I know of. So, definitely check him out. Do enjoy his Draft League content. So, he's got a pretty terrifying team, man. This team is scary. Like, Dragapult, Tapu Koko, and Kieran White are all tremendously giant threats. Alolan Raichu in terrain is also really, really annoying. Mandibuzz, Swampert are super fat, Weezing. Moltres can also be a little bit annoying if it decides to bring them. Honestly, I don't expect them to bring Kling Klang, Sceptile, Weezing, or Moltres. I definitely feel like he's going to bring the top six that I have here or swap Palucho for Alolan Raichu. So, yeah, I'm definitely expecting, obviously, his big three of Dragapult, Coco, and Kieran White, because they're terrifying. Like, they just come in, click buttons, and smack things. Swampert is his only rocker, so I definitely expect that to come, and probably his one of his answers to my Zeraora, potentially. Mandibuzz defensively also does have a decent matchup, and then Hawlucha or Alolan Raichu could be the sweeper here. So, yeah, our first member that we got is going to be Yveltal. We are running Tailwind 3 attacks because I had no idea what to run on Yveltal. Like, Tapu Koko basically stops Yveltal in its tracks. Like, there's nothing I can do for Koko, honestly, with my Yveltal. Hidden Power is gone, so there's not really much I can hit the Koko with super effectively because of Yveltal's moveset. So, yeah, that thing is a little bit annoying, although I still do really good damage. I think if he's not running a lot of HP investment, I could potentially 2-AKO him with the Dark Pulse, depending on rolls. So I was like, I'll take that. It's better than nothing. I do have Sucker Punch as well, just because it could be nice to chip something down if I'm not in Tailwind. I think in Tailwind, I outspeed everything that he could potentially have. So yeah, this could definitely be a nice win condition. Next up, we have Kangaskhan. Look at his team. Look at Kangaskhan. He has nothing to switch into this Kangaskhan. His best answer to my Kangaskhan is going to be Kling Klang, which I would definitely bet money will not be coming to this game, which is why we're running a set that does not touch it whatsoever. And I was kind of debating between what I really wanted to run on this Kangaskhan, so I decided on this kind of tankish set with Early Bird and Rest. Obviously, Rest is a little bit risky because he does have Electric Terrain, which blocks Sleep, but Terrain's not up the entire match. He's just Toxic Mandibuzz. Moltres could switch in. We just Toxic Moltres. If he's running like a fat defensive Weezing, that could be a little bit annoying, but we have other mons to deal with it. So, yeah, Kangaskhan can definitely put in a lot of work here. Next off, we have the Rock, aka Zeraora. This thing is definitely a monster in this matchup. And if he does end up bringing in the Tapu Koko, which I definitely see him bringing just because it is one of his three offensive scary mons. Again, the big three are Dragapult, Koko, and Kieran White. All three of those I would definitely expect to come to this game. I really wasn't sure what I wanted to run on Zeraora here, so I figured that Bulk Up, Plasma Fist, and Play Rough, those three moves guaranteed. And then the last move, I think I had something else over it, but then I realized, well, Swampert is kind of annoying to this essential build, so I figured Grass Knot could be cool. Yeah, Zeraora definitely has merit to put in a lot of work here, especially in Electric Terrain. Like, once Swampert is gone, if Electric Terrain is up, this kind of comes in and I'm basically smacking things with Plasma Fist. And then if I get Bulk up, even though we don't have a lot of attack investment, we can definitely tank hits and dish out some solid damage. So, of course, you guys know he has a Tapu Koko. And we have Nidoking here. Big fan of Nidoking as an answer to Tapu Koko. So, this time around, though, we are running Payapa Berry. I think I also have Pyapa Berry for the Alolan Raichu, so as long as Nidoking can at least take out one of his two offensive electric types, I think that should be more than good enough in this match, honestly. I'm more or less scared of Coco. No, I'm more scared of Coco, sorry, over Alolan Raichu, just because Coco can function without terrain, and if Alolan Raichu is not in terrain, then it's not as scary of a mon. So yeah, this can definitely hopefully beat both of them, but if not, it can at least guarantee beat one of them. And then we have T-Spikes and Rocks, just because T-Spikes are super nice in this matchup if he doesn't have any form of removal, or if he doesn't end up bringing his Weezing, which I think Weezing can run Neutralizing Gas instead of Levitate in Gen 8, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, I'm pretty sure, right? Yeah, so Earthquake and Ice Beam basically hit everything for neutral or super effective damage as well. Next off, we have Charlotte, aka Clefable. You guys already know how much work Clefable has done for us in this season, and in this matchup, it definitely can just win. So with his Fairy Resist being Kling Klang and Moltres, Moltres is not really that big of an issue because we have Zero Aura, we can Toxic it with Kangaskhan, and we have Yveltal that can smack it pretty hard. So once we weaken or get rid of Moltres, which I don't know, I more or less kind of expect Moltres. If it doesn't come, then I wouldn't be surprised. But Kling Klang again, definitely, there's no way Kling Klang is coming. Like I would bet money that there's no way Kling Klang comes to this game. So I'm not even considering that at all. But yeah, once this starts Calm Mining and it gets itself going, then it's a really big problem for him to try and take down. So I definitely see myself winning this week again with Clefable, just because of how good of a matchup it really has. And again, because Unaware and Heavy Duty Boots, we can bluff that we're Magic Guard, so that can definitely come in handy for any type of setup that he could possibly have. And then our final team member is going to be Jirachi. I don't know why I wanted a Calm Mind Jirachi. I'm trying to remember. The Cassiberry is nice. I think it's because if we are able to Calm Mind with the Cassiberry, I think we beat Dragapult 1v1. And of course, Dragapult in normal draft is already like the best Pokemon in the format. So then once that's gone, it's a giant relief off of us. This also acts as a nice pivot into the Kyurem White, so that my Clefable is not my only switch into that. And this is tanky enough to the point where I don't really need to worry about it not doing much in this match. Like, this could more than likely get at least one, maybe two KOs, especially if I do get up a Calm Mind, or he doesn't expect me to be Calm Mind. Or if he does see a Calm Mind, then because of Cassiberry, we could lure in the Dragapult and hopefully get rid of that. So yeah, that's going to be our squad. And with that being said, let's get into the battle.
All right, so this game is being done way earlier than I'm used to playing. It's like 10:30. I'm trying to wake up right now. Yeah, it's like 10:30 a.m. I'm trying to wake up right now. So we are facing Q the Costa Rican. His channel link and stuff will be down below. He did bring the big three, the Dragapult, Kyurem W, the Coco. Apologize for no face cam, guys. I look like the Crypt Creeper right now. I'm out of it. He did bring Raichu. That could be a little bit annoying. And I am just missing Moltres. Moltres is something I did not expect, which is actually kind of bad because we don't really have a fire resist on the squad here. So I kind of want to lead Kangaskhan, I think. Yeah, Kangaskhan, I think, might have been my best lead. Yeah, Pasa YouTube, I forgot all about that. Yeah, so we're facing Q the Costa Rican and the Chicago Dragapults, I believe is his team name. His channel link and stuff will be down below for you guys to go ahead and definitely check out his side of our match and his run of the BBA. I think he is currently 4-2, if I'm not mistaken. So hopefully we can pull a W here. I'm actually not sure what week is this. Week 7? Yeah, I think this is week 7. Okay, I'm trying to wake up. How's it going, guys? Some of you are like, 10:30, Leo, 10:30 is not early. What are you talking about? I'm like, well, good for you. I'm happy that you don't think 10:30 is super early. That means your sleep schedule is not is not all over the place like mine is. So he ends up leading off with the Pert. We're gonna get up a, gonna get off the Toxic on this, because the sooner this is Toxic, the better for us. It will be to deal with, as we do land our Toxic, which is nice. First turn of the game here, so hopefully I can get on my T-Spikes. If he doesn't have Defog on Moltres, this would be amazing. So, I feel like he might try and go for the flip turn here. I could reveal Double Edge. Double Edge would do about 30% of this. The sooner this is gone, the sooner my... my, what's it called? My Zeraora is free in this match. So I might just Double Edge right away. Yeah, I think getting rid of this Swampert is really important. So yeah, ooh, nice chunk of damage there as we put him down to about 60% as he goes for a Toxic of his own. That's fine because we are actually rest with the early bird. So I could actually rest here. Well, no, because if I rest, then he could potentially try to bring in something to set up on me. So that probably would not be the best. Alright, so I'm fine with this damage on Swampert. He's leftovers. I doubt he's going to be rest. I don't know, I thought about Mudsdale not being rest last time, so... who knows? Yeah, I kind of just want to Double Edge again. Right? Yeah, like, after a bulk up, this is in range of play rough. After this Double Edge, so... I'm okay with this. He has no Mandibuzz. Like, this thing is going to be getting smacked pretty hard. So he does go for the flip turn there. He was at about... like 20%, I want to say? 18% around there? So nothing too bad. He's definitely in range of where almost anything will knock him out from whatever we have, which is great. I am a little bit concerned about that Moltres because... my Jirachi can literally not touch it. I need to get rid of Moltres. And that's where hopefully Zeraora can also come in handy. Yeah, Zeraora can kind of go in here. Maybe. It depends what the Dragapult and the Kyurem are running, though. Kalamak is the Kyurem, okay. That thing is scary for sure. Because... dude, Jirachi's so useless in this match. I might just hard Jirachi here. Just to see what his initial move is, because I can still have use for King's Khan in this match. I might have been a little bit risky to have let King's Khan get this low, but... to try and get rid of Swampert, that's really good, I think. I'm also still trying to wake up, like, I don't know... I'm trying to think right now of what to do. Oh yeah, I can calc, right? Because we're switching here. So Kyurem White. He goes for the Ice Beam. Oh, I thought he froze me for a second. I got so scared. He looks like he didn't do too much to us. So, I can probably just Moonblast here, safely. I kind of want to pull a double, too. What would his initial switch into this be? I'm not sure, but I'm going to Moonblast first, see what his initial switch is in. To my Jirachi. So, he does switch. I don't think he's... he could be Scarfed. It is the Moltres, dude. Darn it. I was really hoping Moltres was not a switch into my Jirachi. So we get a special attack drop, which is nice. I think it is 40% because of Serene Grace. So I need a switch here. I'm going to switch into my Clefable. Clefable can also win if Moltres is gone. Or I use it as setup fodder. Dude, Moltres is so annoying. Oh my lord. I need to get off a Toxic on that Moltres. Or just do damage, dude. Okay, so hopefully we can get up Rocks soon in this match. Rocks would be really, really handy. Although if he's boots... well, actually... I mean, if he's boots, it's not the worst thing ever. Scorching sand, please don't burn. Yes. So, I kind of want to call mine here. Would I beat this if I got to like plus six? How much did he do to us? Like 28? Oh, he was at minus one though. So it looks like he might have some special attack investment. So we're gonna call mine first. As he goes for the flamethrower, okay. He's still at minus one, keep in mind. He's doing a lot. I'm gonna moon. No, no, oh no, darn. God. I misclicked. Are you serious, dude? That. Yeah, I'm tired, man. I'm tired. I meant to soft boiled. I can soft boil now, I guess. Oh my god, dude, that's such a hard throw. Because he's in torrent now, too. So flip turn is doing about 30%. Okay, I'm clicking soft boil. Like here, I could have moonblasted. I would be at full HP right now. This should not knock us out. Oh, that had me scared for a second. That had me scared for a moment there. This really sucks, dude, because whatever comes in right now is taking a moonblast to the face. Or would be taking a moonblast to the face. If this is physical Coco, it's not doing too much. Moonblast would smack this really, really hard. I feel like I should moonblast right away here. Well, actually, no, I can go for another soft bold first. See what he wants to do. See if he's physical or special. I don't think he would be bandit or specs, honestly, because we have Nidoking, which is a pretty good answer to this. That whole heal bell turn just put us behind. Because I would have moonblasted this, would have taken like 60, 70%. Okay, so he U-turns, 42, so he did 22 points of damage. He could have some attack investment. Andreas, not right now, go! Alright, so he definitely has, it looks like, a lot of attack investment because he did 22 points of damage, I think, to us. Okay, so we're back from earlier. I definitely Moonblast here. Is it worth Calm Minding again? I mean, whatever comes in is going to be taking good damage. No, I'm going to Moonblast. I could Calm Mind again, honestly. At plus two, though... we don't quite knock out the Coco. So he's going to go for Earthquake here. 202 to 123. That did a good chunk. That did what, like 79? Alright, so we get rid of Swampert. That should have happened earlier. Well, actually, I guess we got out of this how it should have. Although, I guess having the damage on Coco would actually be really nice right now. So my question is, what does he bring in? Yeah, because even if he's Wild Charge Coco, I think we still live a hit. Yeah, unless he's like Choice Bandit. I don't think he's Choice Bandit. No way. Not with me having a Nidoking in the back. So what's he gonna do? The Coco, okay. Oh! I wouldn't be able to softboard on anything. I'm gonna softboard here and see if he is running max attack. Oh, he's got light screen, okay. Why does he have light screen? Wait, that means he might not have wild charge. I think I can calm mind here. This could be a little risky, but I'm gonna calm mind. Oh, please don't. Yes! Okay, that was risky on my end. He did like 98. Okay, so he definitely does not have max attack. Because if he had max attack, he would have done more damage than that to us. Yeah, so here, we can soft-boiled. Pretty safely. And he crit us. Awesome. Alright, well, we lost. Yeah, I think that's game. Oh, dude, that sucks. Because we could have softballed there and then maybe Moonblasted next turn, or I probably would have softboiled. I might have softboiled until terrain was gone. That would have made things so much easier. I'm gonna get a rocks here. Yeah, this is bad. And light screen is up too. This is not looking good for us right now. Because one of our main switch-ins to the Moltres here was Clefable, and he just crit us right out. Yeah, I can't touch this thing either. I can sack Kangaskhan, maybe? I can sack Kangaskhan, bring in Zeraora. Maybe try and get a kill like that. Yeah, we're gonna sack Kangaskhan here. I don't think Kangaskhan would live a flamethrower anyways. Because this thing is pretty offensive. Yeah, this is really, really looking bad right now. We live, but I don't think we're going to be faster, unfortunately. Because we're not really running much speed on this Kangaskhan. Unless he has no speed, we could be faster here. In which case, is it better for me to go for the rest? Flamethrower wouldn't do too much. If I double edge him, that is like 50%, which is really good damage. I think I'm just going to double edge here. I mean, yeah, he doesn't really have anything to take a double edge anyways. Oh, we are faster. Okay. Okay, so that did good damage as we knock ourselves out. I'm hoping he didn't roost there. Yes. Okay, so he's at 40% now, which is great. So we can bring in Zeraora here. So I could risk the Scorching Sand, but I think I'm just gonna Plasma Fist instead. I just need to do damage, man. I need to kill whatever I can right now. If he gives me Moltres, that would be huge. If he gives me this Moltres, that would be amazing right now. Give me this Moltres. Yes! Down goes the Moltres. Awesome. This is huge. Alright, good. Moltres is gone. No! Bro! Come on! Are you serious? No, this is bad. Oh, this is bad. Okay, this is probably justice for my match against Liv, where we won because of Hyper Beam miss. Oh, come on, dude. I just need a Moltres gone and we're in such a good spot. This is still going to be really rough. In comes a Dragapult. This is annoying because we're burned now. This means I can't do anything to this. I just need to stay in and be aggressive. That's like my only play. This really sucks because I'm pretty sure we lived any one hit from this Dragapult too. So then Play Rough would absolutely destroy this. And we're faster. That's just annoying. I could bring in Jirachi and Calm Mind, maybe. Nidoking can come in and Ice Beam, actually. Yeah, okay, I kind of like Nidoking here, maybe. He still has Light Screen up, which is annoying. Yeah. Dude, even if we were burned. Well, no, because, yeah, we're not offensive. We're bulky Zero Aura. Like, we would have done some damage to him. At least, to better put this in range. Okay, let's see. Did Light Screen go down? I have no idea, but I think I'm gonna Ice Beam, I guess. That Coco being at full HP is really problematic. So that's doing zero. Did I throw? I might have thrown. How much HP was Coco at? Coco's still like at full HP because I couldn't get damage off on it. This match has just been really, really bad. I could Jirachi here, maybe. And save Nidoking, that could come in handy, potentially. I don't know what I'm doing, dude. I don't know what I'm doing. This is like, oh, everything's gone so bad. Everything's gone so bad. Can we dodge the Draco? Even though it's gonna do like two. How do you hit two Dracos in a row? I mean, three Dracos in a row. I guess I just flash cannon here? Yeah, I guess I just flash cannon here. I thought he would save this. I don't know. I was trying to think of something to do. Like, we were in such a good spot, and then things just went pretty south for us pretty fast. So he's got U-turn, Wild Charge, Light Screen. And we don't knock him out. Oh, that sucks. Would it be in Sucker Punch range? Actually, no, can we still win this? We can maybe, I don't know, no, probably not. I'm gonna try and flash cannon here, I guess. Alright, so he does light screen. How do we win this? How do we win this? Kiram lives any hit from a Yveltal, even if we were to crit. And then he has the light screen up, which sucks. Yeah, and this is definitely scarfed. I feel like he is going to go for blue flare. I mean, not blue flare, sorry. Fusion flare, potentially. I'm gonna try Moonblast here. Oh, we're faster! I could have gone for Flash Cannon. Oh, we lost. Yeah, we lost. Whoa! Yeah, it's not even in range of Sucker Punch either. Even if I had gone for Flash Cannon, that wouldn't have put it in range. Oh, dude, this sucks. Yeah, I don't even think a crit will knock him out. Oh, okay, so a crit Sucker Punch would actually knock him out. Okay, so if we can crit Sucker Punch here, I think we can win. So we have a chance to win. Alright. We have a small, itty-bitty little chance to win. Unless for some reason he doesn't knock us out with one hit. Ah, man. If he didn't crit Clefable, I think things would have gone so much better. If he didn't crit Clefable, if I was able to get rid of Coco sooner too, I misclicked on the freaking, what's it called, heal bell. That sucks, man. GG. I really feel like I just got really unlucky that game. It's upsetting. It's a little upsetting. I'm not gonna lie. And then, like, Zeraora too, man. Oh well. That's the game. That's just... Oh well. Good game to Q. Obviously nothing against Q, just we got really, really unlucky. Really unlucky. But yeah, hopefully we can bounce back next week. We are still in playoffs potential, so it's not the worst thing ever. But yeah, check out Q, check out his side, check out his run in the BBL, and hopefully we can bounce back next week. So yeah, thank y'all for watching. Later, everybody. My brain and heart are both tied in the knot, and this hinders me from crying a lot. This causing me to show no emotion, but when I said I cared, I wasn't joking. But I guess it's too late for me to become broken. For now, I'm living with no more pain, tears, or hoping. I'm just coasting.
Yeah, I said I'm coasting. No more pain, tears,